If you are getting the FIFA 22 DirectX function error, then we know how to fix it. Watch this video till the end and learn how to solve this problem. Hey, you're watching Silicophilic, the home for all tech users. When you are getting the FIFA 22 DirectX function error, simply perform the solutions shown here to fix it. Before we get into the solution, subscribe to our channel for future tech support. Also, like this video if it helps you solve this issue. Don't forget to comment your feedback on the solutions or if you're facing any issue while performing them. We also have a Facebook group of troubleshooting experts where you can share your tech issues and get direct help. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Now, let's jump into the solutions. The first thing you need to do is edit the fifasetup.ini file. Open Documents on your PC and open the FIFA 22 folder. Right-click on the fifasetup.ini file and open it with Notepad. Change the DirectX_select value to 1 if it's 0 or if it is set to 1, then set it to 0. Save the file and close it. Now try running the game. Method 2. The next thing you can do is check if the graphics driver is enabled. Right-click on the Start menu and select Device Manager. Expand Display Adapters and right-click on the dedicated graphics driver. Select the Enable Device option if the option is available. Method 3. The next thing you can do is add FIFA 22 for high performance in Windows settings. Press the Windows plus I keys to open Settings. Click on System and then select Display. Scroll down and click on Graphics Settings. Click on the Browse option and head to the FIFA 22 installation folder. Select the FIFA 22 EXE and add it. You will now see it here. Click on Options and select High Performance. Select Save to save the changes. If you don't know where the FIFA 22 installation folder is, then open Steam and click on Library. Right-click on FIFA 22 and select the Manage option. Click on Browse Local Files and this will open the installation folder. Remember the address and use it to browse in the graphics settings. Method 4. The next thing you can do is install the latest version of DirectX. What you need to do is search DirectX Runtime Download on Google and open the first result from Microsoft.com. Here, select the installer language you prefer and click on Download. Wait for the download to finish and run the installer. Complete the installation and wait for the installation to finish. While you're waiting, give this video a like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. After the installation completes, restart your PC. Now run FIFA 22 and it should run without the error. Method 5. The next thing you can try is reinstalling the graphics driver. Right-click on Start and select Device Manager. Expand Display Adapters and right-click on the graphics driver. Select Uninstall Device and follow as shown. After the driver is uninstalled, you will have to install it. For AMD graphics driver, you will need to install the Radeon app and run it. Similarly, for NVIDIA graphics drivers, you will need to install the GeForce Experience. Running these apps will automatically detect that the graphics drivers are missing and they will download and install them automatically. Restart your PC once the drivers are installed and run the app again to check for any updates. If any update is available, download and install them. Method 6. Another thing you can try is disabling all the in-game overlay. First, open Origin and click on My Game Library. Right-click on FIFA 22 and select Game Properties. Uncheck the Enable Origin in-game for FIFA 22 box and click on Save. Now open Steam and click on Library. Right-click on FIFA 22 and select the Properties option. Uncheck the Steam in-game overlay option. Method 7. The next thing you can try is disabling the full screen optimization for FIFA 22. Open Steam and click on Library. Right-click on FIFA 22 and select the Manage option. Click on the Browse Local Files option, which will open the FIFA 22's installation folder. Locate the FIFA 22 EXE file and right-click on it. Select the Properties option. Click on the Compatibility tab and check the Disable Full Screen Optimization box. Click on Apply and OK to save the changes. So that's it. If this video has helped you in figuring this issue, then give us a like and subscribe to our channel. If the issue isn't resolved from the solutions we have shown here, comment below to let us know and our team will try their best to help you out. Also join our Facebook group for direct tech support. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching Silicophilic.